was very rural, very country, northern Alberta. I have five brothers, Sid, Ira, Wayne, Cameron, and Owen, and we're all hardworking. Mom brought us up really hardworking people. I didn't have the most splendidest upbringing, I guess you could say. There was a lot of incest in my family, and I just happened to be the one on the receiving end of it. That really messed up my self-esteem. I was bullied at school, my arms being scratched or just being beaten up for being who I am. I didn't appreciate who I was. It really impacted me in the sense that I found I was becoming more promiscuous, and then I'd go through phases of being promiscuous, and then I'd back away from it and I'd be cold about it. Running away with a friend and finding as much alcohol as I could and drinking since I can remember, getting drunk that way, trying to cover up the pain. I had a couple experiences with God when I was still living in the world, and he spoke to me and he says, Audrey, you're going to go places, you're going to meet a lot of people, and you're going to have a son. So I just kind of filed that one away, right? Because I didn't think I was going to have another child. I was done raising kids. But it so happened my last year at Eagleview that I miscarried a baby, and it really traumatized me. The pain of losing my baby carried with me to 118 in Edmonton, and I lived in garages. I was a drug addict, crystal, meth, cocaine, whatever I could get my hands on, marijuana. I met a young fellow and we spent a weekend together, and I didn't know that I was going to have a baby. But that weekend, I phoned my mom and said, Mom, come and get me. I've had enough.
I went and talked to my sister and her husband, and they took me over there, and they helped me bring her home. Oh, she looked rough.
When Ben was born, I have fully surrendered to the Lord. Ben is my little prophet in training. God gave me this little precious bundle of joy that there's just no words to describe the joy that I have from having a little boy in my life. The Audrey who was, I had to go back and love her and wrap my arms around her and tell her to forgive herself, you know.
I would describe that her mind is a lot better. She's more alert and just completely different. I believe it's being hearing God's word over again and being in that atmosphere.
And now today, you see someone who's rearing for school and rearing to go to Israel and enjoy life now and enjoy it with my son.
What you bring, Mommy?
There's no more drugs, no more alcohol. God totally delivered me. There's an answer, and that's if you turn your heart over to God and you really mean it, He will come through for you. He will.